Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Hope you had a great holiday break. We're back here on Wednesday for another podcast. This holiday week, I realize a lot of people aren't at work, so I'm going to go back and do some of my favorite tips from the past. These are some critical tips. If you're new to the podcast, you probably missed our first 100, 200 episodes, and these are some things I just want to make sure that everyone understands. First thing we're going to talk about is entering formulas. You know, when we enter a formula, for example, H2 divided by F2, and copy that formula down a few rows, Excel automatically changes the addresses. So H2 changes to H6, F2 changes to F6, and it allows our formula to work all the way down the column. That's exactly what we expect. But sometimes we might have a setting over here, for example, a tax rate. 6.5% is the local sales tax rate. So if we calculate sales tax from the formula of F2 times L1, when we copy that formula down, it's not going to work. We're going to get zeros everywhere, and when we take a look at one of the copied formulas, we'll see that the F2 changed to F5 exactly like we wanted it to do, but the L1 changed to L4. We want that L1 to always point to L1, and it's called an absolute reference. When you are entering that formula, so you've entered F2 times L1, while the insertion point is right next to the L1, you want to hit the F4 key. The F4 key will put in two dollar signs, dollar sign L, dollar sign 1. That tells Excel no matter where we copy this formula, up, down, left, or right, we always want it to point to L1. Now when I drag the fill handle to copy that formula down, you'll see that we get the right answer. F2 is allowed to change to F5, but L1, because of the dollar signs, always points at L1. It's called an absolute reference. You probably have an occasion to use it maybe once a month. It's really good to know. It's one of those things that you never learn when you're teaching Excel to yourself, but it's very important and can save you lots and lots of time when you need to use it. Called an absolute reference. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you tomorrow for another netcast from Mr. Excel.